If I hadn't like already pretty much committed to like doing a costume with my girls, that's one that like, I don't know, guys. Like, this hair is red, and she had red hair in the video, and my hair will not be red by the time we go on the cruise. But let me put it like this: I could bring this hair with me. You know what I'm saying? to do that costume. But the long like leopard print coat that she had on, like if it's been a while since you've seen the music video for that, don't impress me much. Go look at it, or even like her from the music video for "Man, I Feel Like a Woman." When she was like, you know, all menswear'd out, you know, that could be really cute. But those were some of, that was like one of my favorites from like the music section. I also really like the idea of showing up as Mariah Carey from the music video for Honey. That was one of my favorites. And like, whoever does this, if anyone does this costume, sorry, I gotta delete this thing off my phone, my iPad. One of the ideas that I really liked was Missy Elliott from the music video for The Rain. You're gonna be hot and it's gonna be miserable because you're gonna be in black trash bags, but that was one of my favorite ideas. And then of course I also really love the idea of going as Selena, because Selena. My favorites from the section about 90s costumes inspired by 90s movies and television shows or video games. I really hope someone shows up as, in a T-Rex costume. So like as the T-Rex. Hi, Chantel. As the T-Rex from Jurassic Park, like in one of those T-Rex outfits. I love those so much. And if you come in a T-Rex costume, I want a picture with you so bad, because I've never actually been around one in person, and I have to get. Michelle, you said, oh, you're committed to doing a real shocker. Okay. Wait, Sarah, stop what? I'm confused now, which is not a hard thing to do, so don't feel bad. But yeah, the T-Rex costume, I would be so excited to see someone in that. I think that like kind of as a gender flip, although I know that there were female Men in Black, but like, girl, show up in a black suit, like a black like skirt suit with like a pencil skirt and like a little blinky, like memory blinky thing, and some black sunglasses. And that would be like iconic enough, like people would totally get what you were doing. And like, you might even could get like really clever and like have your black suit and then like splatter it with like some green like gunk, so it looked like you have like alien blood all over you. I don't know if you want to go that far, but yeah. Another one that I really liked was Sabrina the Teenage Witch. So like, particularly in that yellow outfit. So if you can find something that looks like that yellow outfit that she had on in the episode that featured the boys, they would like totally get it. So like, and I think that you'd stand out in a bright yellow outfit. I feel like we are gonna see a lot of girls dressed up as Vivian Ward, like in the version with the short blonde wig from Pretty Woman. I'm calling it now. I think there were a lot of people who were just gonna do that even before I posted that idea. I think we're gonna see a lot of that. So if that's something that you're thinking about doing, more power to you, totally do it. But just know that there's probably gonna be a lot of other girls that are gonna be doing it. And yeah, I also like the idea of Lady Braveheart. And that's a costume, like, you know, paint half your face blue and then like, you know, dress like a barbarian, and you could be like, you could really slut it up if you wanted to, you know? You could take that one as far as you want. As far as costumes inspired by cartoon shows of the 90s, I really, really, really hope someone shows up dressed as Carmen Sandiego. I loved that show as a kid. I used to watch it every day when I came home from school. When I was like really, really little, like 5 and 6 years old, I loved Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego. I also hope someone shows up as Miss Frizzle from the Magic School Bus. Spinelli from Recess would be an easy kind of grungy inspired costume. But if you want to go as like someone specific and like kind of fun, Spinelli from Recess would be a good one. Yeah. And then I've also, like, if you guys just want to Google some of this stuff, I've seen a lot of really cute costumes that were inspired by Be Like Coming, showing up as like a Beanie Baby. Kelly Kapowski from Saved by the Bell, absolutely. Showing up as a troll doll. Guys, that would be awesome. Like, with like, then they have like little belly button jewels. Come on, like, there's so much that you could do with that. My favorite one from like the just random pop culture awesome stuff, though, which I've already posted about, if you guys have seen on social media. Yep, Michelle, I got Daria on this list. I love the Lisa Frank unicorn idea. And if you guys were a little girl in the 90s like I was, then you guys know that Lisa Frank was a life. And there's not just unicorns. You could literally go as Lisa Frank anything. And basically, like, the one that I posted a link to the picture of this girl's costume on the blog. Awesome, yeah. Please come as a troll doll. Please. But yeah, the Lisa Frank costume, like, she had on this necklace that said, like, Lisa Frank, and it was, like, in the logo. And she was just multicolored, and she had the unicorn horn. But, you know, you guys know, like, Lisa Frank would put that little sparkle multicolor nonsense on anything. So you could literally just like Lisa Frank it up and just show up as just like you got attacked by Lisa Frank. I don't care. But like, yeah, I love Lisa Frank. Yeah, Jessica, I think I have, yep, I've got Furby on this list. Yeah. Where's Waldo? You could show up as like, you know, Waldo, or like a lady version of Waldo. One of the ones I really liked from that one, I forgot about it. Getting something white that you can get to stick to your upper lip up here and showing up as an iconic Got Milk ad from the 90s. Because guess who was in a Got Milk ad, guys? If you guys remember when the boys did that ad for Got Milk? I think I was like 11 when that ad came out. And I just thought, like, that's one of my favorite pictures of them. Just, I thought Kevin looked amazing in that picture, even with the ridiculous milk mustache on. But yeah, you could literally show up with a milk mustache and a t-shirt that said Got Milk. And like, if you're, you know, well endowed in the chest area, like some of us are, like, I swear to God, I'm not trying. This is a V-neck t-shirt. But when you have ladies that are large, it always looks like you're trying. And I literally just have on a t-shirt, a button down, and like leggings. It's a struggle, guys, and I'm not being sarcastic. I literally wore a V-neck t-shirt to work today and like got to the office. The first thing I did was ran to the bathroom and flipped it backwards so that like it didn't look like, I don't know, like I was trying to get a promotion that I didn't deserve or something. Like, I don't, like, I just, yeah, it's a struggle. But anyway, so but if you are that way and you want to play it up, literally get like a low-cut t-shirt that says Got Milk and a Got Milk mustache, and boom, costume done. And it probably didn't cost you very much either. So yeah, and then just going to the white party, guys. So my entire outfit for the white party, except for the one last like kind of accessory that I'm waiting for, has come. And like I've said, unbelievably, it fits. Everything fits, and I look better in it than I thought I was gonna look. But my white outfit for Millennium Night is not, I'm like 1999 inspired. I'm not going like I'm in a time machine back to 1999. I'm just going, like I said, cute AF and all white. And I have plans for some accessories that are going to go along with what my outfit is. But I have made it a point this year for these themes so far that above all else, aside from just, you know, being fire hot and whatever I have on, I'm gonna be comfortable from as far as like from a feet perspective. So I'm not wearing heels with anything that I've picked out this year, which is like literally the first time that that's happened in any of the last cruises that I've done. I'm learning, guys. It only took 5 of them. I'm finally getting there. So if you wanna wear heels, if you're good in heels, do you. I'm 5'10", so like I don't get a lot of practice wearing heels because I'm already a giraffe. So like me wearing heels is just kind of like, I feel like I'm walking around on stilts, like towering over everyone, and it's comical. And like the highest heels that I have in my closet are like 3 inches. But even still, like if I'm 5'10", 3 inch heels, I'm over 6 feet at that point. Luckily, my boyfriend is like 6'5", so I can wear heels with him. And also, he likes to hold my hand everywhere we go, so if I'm like stumbling because I'm not used to walking in them, you can't really tell because he's technically holding me up. So we complete each other. He he supports me. Yeah, I just can't see myself, unless whatever the fourth theme, which I've heard through the grapevine we should be getting this Thursday. I'm crossing my fingers and hoping that that's the case. Unless that theme announcement comes out and it's like what I have to come up with is just, I'm not going to be able to do it in anything but heels, then guys, and I will just pop some Aleve before the night begins, preemptively, and just be ready because there are some, for me, I'm one of those girls, like I will suffer through the pain if I have to, if it's going to be what's going to make it, make me feel like I've completed the look. If I don't like the whole thing, it just, I won't be confident in it, and then it just, it'll be a flop because I don't feel good in it. So if I have to wear heels, I will, but we'll see.